I'm missing my headphone, so let me know if you can't hear properly, so and then probably switch to computer.
You can hear.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, we can hear you fine. Good morning.
Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavatpada Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Bhagavanto Punah Punaha Ishwaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Yoma Vadhyapta Deha Yidakshina Murtaye Namaha Rukara Sundakaro Vairukara Stannivartakaha Andhakara Niroditvad Guru Ritya Vidiyate Om Sahana Vavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Sahabibhyam Karavavahi Tejasvinavadhitamastuma Vidvishavahi Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Om Brahmavida Apnoti Param Tadeshabhyukta Satyam Jnanamanantam Brahma Yovedanihitam Guhayam Paramevyoman So Oshnute Sarvan Kama Amsaha Brahmana Vipaschiteti Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Bahusyam prajaye yeti satapo tapyata satapas tapva itagum sarva masrijata. Bahusyam prajayeya. Before that we saw sokamayata. Then bahusyam prajayeya. Saha Brahman. Tad Brahman. Akamayata, it desired. What did it desire? Bahusyam, bahubhutam, bahubhaveyam. Bahu prabhutam syam bhaveyam. May I become many. May I become manifold. So that is its desire. So we saw that desire here means Brahman is not just the material cause alone, but it is also the intelligent cause. Big Bang theory also talks about manifestation, but it is manifestation of matter in the form of this world, because it was in a high heated form and then it started cooling down, then Big Bang happened and then it became entire thing. Now here Shastra is not talking about just the material cause alone manifesting, but also an intelligent cause. In fact, both material and intelligent cause are presented as Brahman, because we have to answer for the sake of understanding that everything is Brahman. We need to understand how Srishti is. So the Srishti is presented with an intelligent cause and material cause, because every Srishti needs an intelligent cause and material cause. The moment you say Srishti, there has to be an intelligent cause, because creation implies a creator. Therefore, here this akamayata, desired, the word is used to show that Brahman is not just the material cause, but an intelligent cause as well. Therefore, bahu prabhutam syam bhaveyam, may I become many, iti it desired. Katam ekasya artantara anupraveshe bahutvam syad, iti uchyate. Question is, how can one, when it enters another, can become manifold? So that is where some of these drishtantas take that agnehe vispulinga iva. So they sahasra sirusha purushaha, all that is taken as one fire. As it gets split into many sparks, so too this Brahman has become many and all that. So there is such interpretation, but it is not okay, everything looks same, but actually it is not same as what we say from Vedanta perspective, because this Agnir Vishpulinga also, if it is that way, that it implies what is the upadhi, so is space other than Brahman, all that questions will come. So here we will see, Bhashyakara will take Nama Rupa as the upadhi, and without Svarūpa Parityagena, without abandoning its Svarūpa, the Brahman has become many. Is the vision. Kathamekasya attantara anupraveshe bahutvam syad. How can one thing, by entering into another, become many? So is the question. Uchyate. So it is answered. Prajayeya utpadyeya nahi putrotpatya pativa artantara vishayam bahu bhavanam katam tarhi atmastha anabhivyakta namarupa abhivyaktya. So is it like putrotpatti, like giving birth to progeny? Is that how artantara bahu bhavanam? So one person became two after marriage, then it became, that person becomes three, putrotpatti, four, five, etc. That's how this bahu bhavanam. So I am many because I have given birth to so many kids. Is it like that? Is it putrotpatti? No, na, it is not that way. Then what? Katam tarhi? Then how is it atmastha? So in residing in Atma or Brahman, Atmastha, Atme Tishtati, Atmani Tishtati, Atmastham. What is in Atma? Anabhivyakta Namarupa. This name and form is in unmanifest form. So that unmanifest name and form, Abhivyaktya, by it becoming manifest. So we saw in the last class, in deep sleep, everything is unmanifest. It is in the seed form. Even your own identity is in a seed form. When the dream happens or when the waking happens, it manifests. Everything manifests to you. So that manifestation is called abhivyakti. But then here, it is not out of our will that this anabhivyakti and abhivyakti take place. But in the case of Ishvara, this whole jagat is an abhivyakti of what? Nama Rupa, the name and form. So everything here is a name and a form. And one name implies many names. Like a cloth is one name. Then fiber is another name. Yarn is another name. Like that, it gets into many names. So the moment I say body, human body, that's one name. Within that, again, names head, hand, leg, Then if you take hand, it has fingers, arm, then forearm, all that. Then if you take finger, then again skin, nerves, bones. Again you take bone, it becomes another set of names, calcium, whatever, marrow. So it goes on and on. Any one name gives, lends itself to many other names. So the whole creation is of name, 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 and the name is associated with the form. The moment I say elephant, there is an elephant form. So there is a name, there is a form. Vagartha viva sampritto. We saw in the last class. Vak and artha, name and form, are inseparable. So this name and form is what is creation. That is the upadhi. There is no substantive there. That's what it means. So when we say upadhi, it's not like a clay becoming pot where there is a change. That is called parinami upadana karana. The material undergoes a change and becomes pot because it is heated and it has attained a new shape, which is due to, and it become hard, and that is called parinami upadana karanam. Here Brahman is vivarta upadana karanam. It doesn't undergo any change. Svarūpa aparityagena eva. So without giving its nature, it becomes. Therefore name and form is the upadhi. Atmastha anabhivyakta namarupa abhivyaktya. This namarupa is unmanifest before srishti, and there is an abhivyakti, manifestation, which is srishti. The question will be, does it happen in time? So when was it anabhivyaktam? When is it abhivyaktam? It happened 2000 years back, or 5000 years back, or 1 million years back, will be the question. Now this abhivyakti, the cause, the effect, or srishti, includes time. Time is also srishtam. Desham is also srishtam. That is, space is also created. Also a manifest. Therefore, time, space and object are manifest. So we are not talking about a manifestation in time. So that has to be understood. Now that means the srishti that is spoken is only to understand what is. There is no real srishti. There is no srishti. In fact, the jagat is Brahman, but Brahman is not jagat. Like a fiber or a yarn or cotton is not cloth, but cloth is cotton. So because when cotton has to be cloth, then whenever you think of cotton, you should be only thinking of cloth, but that's not the case. Therefore, A is B, B is A, but A is not B. Similarly, Jagat is Brahman, but Brahman is not Jagat. Therefore, Jagat is Mithya, Brahman is Satyam. It is only name and form. There is no substantive. Therefore, Atmastha Anabhivyakta Namarupa Abhivyaktya Srishtihi. That is why it is Bahubhavanam. Manifestation into manifold jagat. Yada atmaste anabhivyakte namarupe vyakriyate tada atmasvarupa aparityagena eva. So this is what we were saying. Atmasvarupa aparityagena, without leaving itself, without abandoning its svarupa, it became brahmanaha apravibhakta deshakale sarvavastasu vyakriyete. तदा तन नामरूप व्याकरणम ब्रह्मणः बहुभवनम् explains यदा तन आत्मस्ते अनभिव्यक्ते नामरूपे result dual रामे I mean राम रा रमे right आत्मस्ते अनभिव्यक्ते नामरूपे so the residing in atma as unmanifest the name and form vyakriyate tada when they become when they manifest then atma swarupa aparityagena eva brahmanah apravibhakta deshakale sarva avasthasu vyakriyate in all avasthas what is an avastha sukshma avastha stula avastha or jagrat avastha swapna avastha all that so in the state of waken in the state of dream when all these different states there is this manifestation of time space etc see the apravibhakta deshakale so this apravibhaktam not just nama rupa but deshakala also time space name form everything is unmanifest and then it becomes manifest means it is this manifestation and unmanifestation also is within mithya only but to understand first you have to understand we can't just say if I just start and stop with hey everything is brahman then there is no teaching so in order to teach we need to start with what we how we see this jagat and then that the teaching brings out the swarupa of what actually is therefore this pravibhaktam apravibhaktam all that is to make you understand that all that is here is brahman so when you understand this you have to understand it in the right way that shastra is bringing out this abhivyakti of nama rupa and abhivyakti of desha and kala as well the time and space and things time and space also is name and form only the moment I say today tomorrow it is a certain understanding and when I say space that also avakasha pradatra akasham means it has a certain attribute that we understand the dimensionality it's also a name and form therefore time and space also comes within name and form only because we can recognize any of these things only if it as an attribute therefore sarva avasthasu apravibhakta deshakale vyakriyate tada tan nama roopa vyakaranam brahmanah bahubhavanam in that way that name and form the manifestation is what is called bahubhavanam of the brahman became many this many is only manifestation of name and form which was in unmanifest form even when we talk about srishti from pralaya we say ishvara creates that is a manifestation but in pralaya he resolves everything that's why in lord shiva's statue the eyes are shown half closed so half closed is unmanifest and half open is the manifest so that's how the srishti is na anyatha niravayavasya that's why buddha statue is shown with fully closed eyes shunya na anyatha निरवयवस्य ब्रह्मणः बहुत्वापत्तिः उपपद्यते अल्पत्वं वा निरवयवस्य ब्रह्मणः बिकॉज द ब्रह्मन डस नॉट हैव एनी अवयवा पार्ट्स देयरफॉर बहुत्वापत्तिः बहुत्वापत्तिः न अन्यता उपपद्यते So if there is no part, becoming many as a sentence doesn't make any sense. If there is an avayava, there is a part, then it can become many. It can split into different things. There is a tree. The tree can break up into trunk, bark, branches, leaves, fruits, vegetables, all that, because it has parts. Then you can split it up. Even a lump of clay, it is as though it has parts because it has the minute pieces to it. So because it has a shape and all that, so we can split it. Whereas Brahman does not have any avayava. It doesn't consist of parts. Because it's chit ganam, it is chin matram, it is satta surupam. Therefore, there is no avayava. Niravayavasya brahmanaha bahutva apattihi na anyatha upapadyate. Unless you take it as ya vivarta upadana karana, where the name and form is manifested as though, unless you understand it that way, there is no other way you can understand a niravayava brahman becoming many. Nor alpatvam, or only few. You can neither say there are only few that Brahman became, or there are manifold that Brahman has become. Either of them is not possible unless you take it this way. This is what Bhashyakara says. Yatha akashasya alpatvam bahutvam cha vastuantara kritameva. So he takes an unlike example. Okay, like in the case of Akasha. Akasha has an alpatvam and bahutvam. There is an Akasha alpatvam bahutvam because of vastu antara kritam. Like a small part, there is a part space. There is a, in the ear of the needle, the hole, needle hole, there is a small tiny space. And then in this room, there is a large space. Like that, there is an alpatvam, there is a part space and a room space. Alpatvam and bahutvam, how is it happening? Because of vastuantara kritam. There is this room structure. That is a vastu other than akasha. Then there is this part structure, which is other than this akasha. So like that, vastu antaram is there, vastu antara kritam, bahutvam, alpatvam, akashasya, it is as though, again, vastu antara doesn't, it just, with the upadhi drishti, from the standpoint of the room and the part, there is a part space and the room space. But we, like we discussed yesterday, the part and room are themselves within the space only. So this is an unlike example. Though some people take it as a like example also, because upadhi, name and form, separates Brahman. But the problem, if we take it as a like example, then the question is the reality of name and form is not equivalent to the reality of Brahman. Whereas in the case of Akasha and part and all that, they have equal reality. So therefore, this example we have to understand properly. Because in the case of Brahman, when we say upadhi, because that's one common error people will make. Because we are used to thinking in terms of objects, many objects and all that. So the moment we say there is upadhi and the Brahman, because we read this, everything is Atma, Atma is what is your soul, it is what is sitting inside this body, all that, then people think just like there is a hand, leg and all that, there is also an Atma which is inside the heart or whatever, in when so somewhere inside there is this Atma sitting in a particular shape, and then there is it is, this Atma is there in every body. So it's, so people take that, even people who try to understand Vedanta and Shastra, they immediately imagine Atma as a there is a Deha Vyatirikta individual soul which sits everywhere. So that's how people take. Even some of the sampradayas also talk like that. When Bhagavad Gita, when they try to explain Hare Krishna and all these people, they take it as a soul. So Nainam Chindanti Shastrani, Nainam Dahati Pavakaha, all that Bhagavad Gita says, then they say this body alone can be hurt. The Atma which is sitting inside it, it cannot be touched, all that stuff. But if you act, so if you take it in isolation, that's how it will sound. But Bhagavan also makes statements like Astani Sarva Bhutani Nachaham Teshu Avastitaha, and then Nachamastani Bhutani, all those things he also says elsewhere in Bhagavad Gita. So all things are in me, but I am not in any one of them. So those kind of statements are made. So if it is a deha, if it is only about an Atma sitting in each body, then that kind of a statement is not possible. Also, when we give reality to the body equal to the Atma, then there is no question of Satyam Mithya and Moksha and all that. Therefore, we cannot take this Akasha Alpatvam as a like example to show what is Brahman. It is only an unlike example. There, Bhashyakara also in the next line makes it clear. He says, Ataha Tadvarena Eva Atma Bahubhavati Nahi Atmanaha Anyate Anatma Bhutam Tatra Vibhakta Desha Kalam Sukshmam Vyavahitam Viprakrishtam Bhutam Bhavat Bhavishyadva Vastu Vidyate. See, he clearly tells Atmanaha Anyati. Other than it being Atma, Anatma Bhutam, it not being Atma, Tatra Vibhakta Desha Kalam Sukshmam. So any subtle, Vyavahitam, separated spatially, Viprakrishtam, differentiated as different objects, Bhutam, that was in the past, Bhavat, present, Bhavishyat, in future, Va, Vastu, Asti, Vidyate. So there is nothing other than Brahman or Atma, which is separated by time or space. So spatiality, he says, Vyavahitam, Viprakrishtam. And separated by time, he is bringing out Bhutam Bhavat Bhavishyat, in the past, in the present, in the future. So there is no object, there was never an object, there will never be an object other than it being Atma. Nahi Atmanaha Anyat Anatma Bhutam Tat Pravibhakta Deshakalam Sukshmam Vyavahitam Viprakrishtam Bhutam Bhavat Bhavishyadva Vastu Vidyate. There is nothing else other than Brahman. There was nothing else other than Brahman. There will never be anything against that Brahman in time or spatially or separated. Therefore, that example of space is unlike example. So in the case of space, because there is a reality to a non-space object. Because he is saying, Vastu Antara Kritam Eva Akashasya Alpatvam Bahutvam. The Vastu Antara means the other than the Akasha. Things other than Akasha separate Akasha into many. Whereas in the case of Brahman, there is nothing other than it. So it's only name and form. The name and form Upadhi, name and form is not a substantive. Name and form is a mithya, is a upadhi by which Brahman is seen as many. Even that upadhi doesn't have an existence or substantive of its own. Therefore, this Atmanaha Bahubhavanam is only a manifestation, it's a superimposition of a certain experience. Tataha namarupe sarva avasthe brahmanaha eva brahmana eva atmavati na brahma tadatmakam. Okay. So does this namarupa have any existence? Sarva avasthe, in every avastha, brahmana eva namarupe atmavati. The namarupa have their existence in only Brahman. Na brahma tadatmakam. Brahman is not deriving its existence from name and form. It's only name and form which is deriving its existence from Brahman. Te tat pratyakhyane nastaha eveti tadatmake uchyate. If there were to be no Brahman, they cannot exist. The name and form cannot exist. Without an akasha, can room exist? Without an akasha, again, we are not able to experience any of this. But in this case, but at least akasha and the pot are two different things. They limit each other. Whereas here, everything, nothing can be thought of without it being Brahman. You cannot think of a pot without a substance which makes the pot. Think of a pot. The moment I say think of a pot and you think of a pot, you have to think of the substance which makes the pot. Either it should be a clay, or it should be a stainless steel, or it should be aluminium, whatever. But the substance goes with it. Similarly, this jagat, isness, what is, mat is, the satta is there in every name and form that we think of. Etat pratyakhyane nastaha eveti tadatmake uchyate. So without atma or brahman existing, name and form's existence cannot be conceived. Tabhyam cha upadibhyam nyadrugnyeya jnana sabdarthadi sarva samvyavahara bhag brahma. So due to these upadis, which upadi? Name and form are the upadi. Because of that, nyadrugnyeya jnana, the knower, known, and the knowledge, sabdarthadi sarva samvyavahara bhag brahma. The whole experience, human experience or any experience, is about jnatrujnaya jnanam. I have an object of knowledge. I am the subject and that knowledge, and then the knowledge itself. These three is the vyavahara. Now, the jnata is through the upadhi of buddhi and all that. The jnayam is through the upadhi of sound, light, touch, smell, and all that. Jnanam is vṛtti and all this upadhi base. All these are lighted up by Brahman. The sound, light, touch is lighted up by Brahman. The knowership is lighted up by Brahman. The vṛtti, which is in the form of, the knowledge which is in the form of vṛtti, is also lighted up by same Brahman. Therefore, this jnatrujnaya jnaya jnana is the reason for the vyavahara. Sabdarthadi sarva sam vyavahara bhag bhujyate. This Brahman is experiencing this jnatrujnana jnaya because of this name and form upadhi. And what are these upadhis? Like we said, vṛtti upadhi, sound upadhi, whatever. So, this name and form upadhi leads to jñātra jñāna jñeya viṣaya, and because of this, this vyavahara takes place, and that vyavahara is experienced by this Brahman. So this Mithya Nama Rupa, which is in the form of Jnatri Jnaya Jnana, is what is this Jagat. So Satyam Mithya is what is explained very clear, very clearly here. Sa Atma Evam Kamaha Sanne Tapaha Atapyata Sokamayata Bahusyam Prajayeti Satapo Tapyata. That's the next sentence. Satapo Tapyata Saha Tapaha Tapyata. What does this tapas mean here? Evam Kamaha, in this, with this kind of a desire of Bahubhavanam, that Atma Tapaha Atapyata, he did tapas. What is this tapas? Tapaha iti jnanam uchyate tapa alochane. So tapaha can mean many things. In this case, tapaha is used in the context of alochanam, jnanam. Okay, knowledge. And he uses another Shruti Vakya to establish this in Mundaka Upanishad. Yasya jnanamayam tapaha. So there the word is used for Brahman. The tapas is in the form of knowledge. Jnanamayam iti shrutyantarat. So another Shruti is taken to show that this tapaha here means jnanam. So Brahman can't go and sit and do a tapas. Hey, I want to become any one. Then who is going to come and give the boon for Brahman? Okay, may your tapas be fulfilled. There is nothing else. So therefore, here tapas has to mean knowledge, because that's this way to understand tapas as knowledge. And there is another Shruti which shows Yasya Jnanamayam Tapaha. Tapalochane also, as the word tapaha is used in the form of knowledge. Aptakamatvat cha itarasya asambhavaha eva tapasaha. So what other thing can be for Brahman? Because it's an aptakama, it doesn't have any kama. So it is aptakama. It has all fulfilled. It has no unfulfilled desire. Not that it has all been fulfilled. We can't say that way. It doesn't have an unfulfilled desire. Therefore, since it doesn't have, so then there is no need for, so tapas is done for somebody who has a desire, who wants to achieve something, then say the person does tapas. But here, aptagamasya brahmanaha, there is no tenability, it is untenable to do a tapas. Itarasya asambhavaha eva tapasaha. You can't take any other meaning for tapas, because Brahman is aptagama. So then the tapas is only jnanam. Jnanamayam. Tat tapaha atapyata taptavan. So what is this then tapas? Vashyagara says, Srijyamana Jagadrachanadi Vishayam Alochanam Akarot Atma Ityartaha. So when we talk about Srishti, Ishvara does Pralaya and Srishti, Pralaya and Srishti and all that, Ishvara has a view of what has gone by in the previous Srishti and has to recollect and then again manifest a new Srishti. Because when it is all knowledge, there is no need to recollect and all that. Okay. What is all knowledge is Brahman. So that all knowledge is manifesting as this Jagat. But figuratively, we use this kind of, he recollects what went in previous Srishti and creates the new Srishti, because it's the same Jivas which have to continue in the new. So we talk about Pralaya and Srishti in figurative expressions, then in that context, the previous srishti is remembered and same jiva, same karma is brought forth and a new srishti happens. Srijyamana jagat rachanadi vishayam alochanam alochanam akarot atma. Srijyamana jagat, the jagat which has to be created, rachanadi vishayam, how it has to be created, that is rachana. Okay, that alochanam akarot atma, the atma envisions how it has to be done. Ityartaha. That is how we understand this. Because that satapo tapyata. Okay, so even if it is in jnanamayam, that jnanamaya tapa is that envisioning how the srishti is going to be. Saha evam alochya tapaha taptva prani karmadi nimitta anurupam idam sarvam jagat deshataha kalataha namna rupena cha yathanubhavam sarvaihi pranibhi sarva avastaihi anubhuyamanam asrijata srishtavan. Evam alochya, in this way envisioning tapaha tattva, so doing this tapas which is in the form of knowledge, what does this Brahman do? Prani karmadi nimitta anurupam. So the srishti means what? Srishti means different lives, living beings and things that these living beings interact with. But interact based on what? Karmadi nimittam. Because of karma. Because who benefits what, who enjoys what, who experiences what, has to be through what? Karma only. So the karma and prani are the two main things. And Adipada is anyway there. Other things also, like all the objects. Other than prani, there are also things like sun and moon, which are not pranis. So, but main two things are prani, life forms, and karma. So, without these are two essentials. Without karma, you can't say which prani has to be born and where it has to be born, when it has to be born, what kind of experience that prani has to undergo. All that is based on karma, punya baba only. Therefore, Bhashyakara lists these two first. Prani, karma, adi, nimitta, anurupam. That is how this srishti is. Srishti means there are pranis, there is karma. And the objects that the karma makes you experience. Prani, karma, adi, nimitta, anurupam. Idam sarvam jagat. Idam means this cognition. Whatever is in the form of this cognition is jagat. That's all. So whatever I cognize as this in sitting at wherever I am is the jagat for me. Therefore, idam sarvam jagat. Jagat always goes with idam. Okay. Because it is in the discognition. The I cognition is not jagat. Jayate gacchati iti jagat. That which comes and goes as an experience. That cannot be I. That is only this. Therefore, idam, whenever we say idam, whenever say we say jagat, we say idam sarvam jagat. Desataha, palataha, namna, rupena cha. So how is this jagat being experienced? It is experienced spatially, desataha. That is speciality, dimensionality. I am here, I am there. This is in front of me. So desataha, palataha. I experience it this time, that time. I was experiencing, I am experiencing, I did experience, I am experiencing, I will experience. That is kalataha. My dad experienced it. His dad experience. So these are kalataha. Namna, in this form, with this name, namna, so this is this experience with that name. So this is a watch. This is a cell phone. this is a joke. All that emotion also has a name. This is an anger. Rupena, then the form, this round sun, this crescent moon, all that is my experience. Deshataha, kalataha, namna, rupena cha, yathanubhavam, that which is experienced in all this form, sarvaihi pranibihi, for all the living things, sarva avastaihi, in all avastas, the experience is not only in vekan, even a dream is an experience. There also some papas will go, right? If you have a dream where there is a tiger which is coming and hurting you and you experience a pain, that means some papa is gone in dream also. So some prarabdha only is leading to that kind of an experience in that dream state for you. So that avastha also is an experience. Sarva avasthaihi anubhuyamanam. So the anubhuyamanam means that which is experienced. Asrijalta srishtavan. That kind of a srishti is done by Brahman. So the space, so he brings everything here. On one sentence, the whole srishti, how Brahman is doing the srishti, has brought out. We read again, eva malochya, this jnanamayam tapaha tattva. In this way, conceiving this jagat, how is he doing the srishti? What kind of srishti? Prani karma dinimitta anurupam, in the form of life and the karma, idam sarvam jagate, that which is in the this cognition, desataha kaladaha namna rupena chayatana bhavam, in the form of spatiality, in the form of time, in the form of name and form, whatever is experienced as this jagat, chayatana bhavam, sarvai pranibihi, sarva avastaihi, and that experience is in the form of wake and deep sleep and dream. Anubhuyamanam asrijata srishtavan. So the srishti is, what is srishti? So when you talk of srishti, you are not talking about in third person. There is a, you know, big bang and something came. It is the srishti is very closely tied to my experience. That is srishti. Yeah, you don't talk in third person. It is always in first person. My experience of what is there is srishti. So you have to bring in karma. You have to bring in Deshakala Nama Rupa. Then only that is Srishti. So Idam Jagat. What is recognized by me, cognized by me as this cognition is Jagat. There is nothing other than Jagat. Without my experience, where is Jagat? So my experience is Jagat. You can't talk about Srishti is, you know, some big bang happened, something happened there, all that, right? We are talking about this, what I am seeing, my experience. Therefore, Bhashyakara, when he talks about Srishti, he brings all that in the context of my experience. So then my state of life, so that's why the deep sleep and waken and dream, all that is, when we talk about Srishti, you have to talk about all this. So it is very personalized to what is experienced by me. Not about, you know, some, you know, third person thing, right? Where we are talking about Srishti, in science we talk about Big Bang, all that. It is not a personal, we don't talk about three avastha, all that, right? Name and form, all that. So this Srishti is very different. That's why I am emphasizing that. When we talk about Srishti, it's not how science talks. Not about, the scope of it is very different. I'm not against what science talks and all that. Science is looking at it in a different context. But here, Srishti is with reference to my experience. It is Srishti. Because we are trying to understand my experience, what is going on here. That's all. We are not here to arrive at how mutation happened, how genetics has come, all that. That is not the context here. Vyavastha is different. Vyavastha is, I am having an experience called a world. So that experience is being examined here. That is what is the intent. That is the vyavastha. Not to spend a lot of time of how the evolution has happened, what happened millions of years back, all that. That is not the Srishti. That is why this, when Shastra is talking about Srishti and we are Vedanta focusing on Srishti, it is, the objective is to recognize what is the experience and moksha. Mukti is the context, right? So you have to understand it in so that it liberates and the Brahma Jnanam takes place. That is the context. So our focus is not to explain how Srishti is happening. The focus is to understand how everything is Brahman. Therefore, here Srishti is within the is with reference to my experience. So idam sarvam jagat. So this cognition, whatever is in the realm of this cognition for me, in the three avastas, so how has that Srishti taken place? Is what is explained by Vashyaka. Sarva avastaihi anubhuyamanam asrijata srishtavan. All this experience which is there and this cognition for me was manifested by Brahman only. Yadidam kincha, yad kincha idam avasishtam. Without leaving anything, whatever little bit is left out, that is also part of the same Srishti only, Brahma Srishti. Tadidam jagati srishtva kimakarot. So after having created this, tatapo tapyata satapas taptva, therefore, tadeva srishtam jagat anupravishad iti, tat srishtva tadeva anupravishate. Okay. After having created, then what did it do? Srishtam jagat anupravishad iti, it entered. Okay, it entered into this jagat. Then some interesting questions come up. We'll just raise it next class, we can see. Tatra yetat chintyam, Vashyakara starts a discussion here. We need to think about this yetat chintyam. We need to understand this better. What? Katam anupravishatiti, how can it enter? This is the question. So when I say clay has become pot, after that clay entered into pot. That's how the statement is. Tat srishtva tadeva anupravishati, that alone entered. How is it possible when clay has become a clay pot? After that clay entered into pot means what? That it doesn't make sense. This is a question which is brought out. Kim yaha srashta taha tenaiva atmana anupravishate uta anyena. So he asks a question. Yaha srashta, the one who is a creator, taha tenaiva atmana anupravishate, that creator alone went in. So a pot maker creates a pot and goes and sits inside, like we build this house and go in and sit inside the house, correct? Is that how it is? Or uta anyena atmana, or some other atma, somebody else is brought in. Kim tavad yuktam, how is it possible? Iktva pratyaya shravanat yaha srashta saheva anupravishaditi. So he is explaining this iktva pratyaya. Srishtva anupravishati is what is a shastra. So because that iktva is used, so then means in Sanskrit, when you say srishtva anupravishati, then same person only is implied. Iktva pratyaya shravanat yaha srashta sahayeva anupravishati, that person alone anupravishati entered. But then the question comes, nanu na yuktam mritchet karanam mridvachet karanam brahma. But how is that possible? When clay, like if it is like a clay becoming pot, the pot maker cannot enter into the pot, no? Mridvachet, I mean, when so the pot structure, he cannot get in. I mean, he can make a big pot and sit inside it. That's a different thing. But in the, when we say pot, clay, when any object, let's say I make a bangle, I cannot get into the bangle. Nayuktam tadatmakatvat karyasya. Already it has, karyam is tadatmakam. So, if Brahman is the material cause, then it is already in the form of what has been created. Then where is the question of separately again entering into it? Is the question. Tadatmakatvat karyasya. Karanamevahi karyatmana parinatam. So the karanam only has been modified into becoming this karya. If that is the case, ityataha apravishtasya eva karyotpattehe urdhvam krutak karanasya punapravesaha anupapannaha. Again separately entering into it doesn't make any sense, because clay has already become part. Where is clay left for it to again enter? You can say clay is in the form of pot, that's fine. So that's what he says. Karanamevahi karyatmana parinatam. The cause only has already modified itself into the effect. Ityataha, if that is the case, apravishtasya eva karyotpattehe urdhvam. After the karya has been created, prithak karanasya punapraveshaha anupapannaha. Again, separately saying that this karana has entered this karya is untenable. How is it possible? There is a question. Also, he gives one more logic. The Purva Pakshi says, Nahi Gata Parinama Vyatirekena Mridaha Gate Praveshaha Asti. So, other than being a modification of clay into being pot, there is no entry of clay into pot. It is only, we can only say, mrit has, clay has modified itself to pot. So in the example also, he takes the same thing. This kind of a discussion, so basically is trying to understand this pravesha. See, already bahubhavanam has been discussed. What is this becoming manifold? Has been discussed, but what is this anupravesha, entering into it? What does it mean? So that has to be understood. That is the discussion which starts. It's a little long discussion, so we'll see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Arihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Arihi Om.
Pranam Guruji, do you have 1-2 minutes?